In this example, we will call the same sub-procedure multiple times in a program. One of the great benefits of modular programming is that it allows you to reuse procedures as many times as you like. Let's say we want to make a simple sub-procedure that takes two arguments as input and tells the user the sum of those two arguments. Here we see that the sub-procedure addy is called twice within the macro main. When we run this code, we create 5 message boxes. A equals 1, B equals 2, X equals 5, Y equals 6. The sum of 1 plus 2 equals 3. A equals 900, B equals 2, X equals 5, Y equals 6. The sum of 5 plus 6 equals 11. And finally, A equals 900, B equals 2, X equals 900, Y equals 6. Let's examine why these message boxes appear. We create a sub-procedure named main and declare 4 variables, a, b, x, and y. These variables are given a double data type. Next, these variables are assigned values. A is assigned the value 1, b is assigned the value 2, x is assigned the value 5, and y is assigned the value 6. A message box appears that states, A equals, then the value of A, comma, B equals, the value of B, comma, X equals, the value of X, comma, Y equals, the value of Y. At this location in the program, A has the value 1, B has the value 2, X has the value 5, and Y has the value 6. Next, the program calls the sub-procedure addy, which has 2 arguments. The current sub-procedure that we're in, which is named main, halts until addy is completed. Notice that the 2 arguments in the calling statement are named A and B. But the arguments down below, where addy is defined, have the names M and N. The first argument in the calling statement list, A, becomes linked to the first argument in addy, which is named M. If M changes in addy, A will be affected in main. Similarly, the second argument in the calling statement list, B, becomes linked to N in addy. If N changes in addy, B will be affected in main. When the sub-procedure addy begins, M starts with the value of A in main, which is 1, and N starts with the value of B in main, which is 2. Notice that we do not need to declare the variables M and N in addy, because they are in the argument list. All variables in the argument list are automatically declared when the sub-procedure begins. M and N are given the same data types as A and B in main, which is double. We do need to declare variables that are not in the argument list, such as answer. Answer is declared as a double variable and assign the sum of M and N, which is 3. If we did not declare answer, we would receive an error message. Next, a message box is created stating the sum of the value of M plus the value of N equals answer. In this case, the message box will state the sum of 1 plus 2 equals 3. And finally, M is assigned the value 900. The sub-procedure addy is terminated and we return to main. Remember that the value of M has changed to 900 in addy, which means the value in A will also change to 900 since the 2 variables are linked together. The variable n has not changed its value in addy, So the value in B will remain 2. X and Y in main were not passed down to Addie, so their values are still 5 and 6. A third message box appears that states A equals the value of A, B equals the value of B, X equals the value of X, and Y equals the value of Y. So the message box will state A equals 900, B equals 2, X equals 5, and Y equals 6. Next, the subprocedure Addie is called a second time, and the subprocedure main halts until Addie is completed. The first variable in the calling statement argument list, X, becomes linked to M in Addie. If M changes in Addie, X will be affected in main. The second variable in the calling statement argument list is Y, and this becomes linked to N in Addie. If N changes in Addie, Y will be affected in main. The variables A and B in main will not be affected because they are not in the calling statement argument list this time. When the subprocedure Addie begins, M starts with the value of X in main, which is 5. N starts with the value of Y in main, which is 6. As before, we do not need to declare M and N in Addie because they are in the argument list and given the same data types as X and Y in main, which are double. Answer is declared as a double variable and assigned the sum of M and N, which is 11. A fourth message box appears that states the sum of the value of M plus the value of N equals the value of answer. The sum of 5 plus 6 equals 11 will appear on the screen. M is then assigned the value of 900 and the subprocedure is terminated. Now we go and return to main. The value of M in Addie is linked to the value of X in main. Since the value of M in Addie was changed to 900, the value of X in main is now also 900. The value of N in Addie remained unchanged, so the value of Y in main is still 6. A and B in main were not passed down to Addie, so their values are still 900 and 2. The fifth and final message box states A equals the value of A, comma, B equals the value of B, comma, X equals the value of X, comma, Y equals the value of Y. So the last message box states A equals 900, B equals 2, X equals 900, Y equals 6. This example demonstrates many important features of calling subprocedures. A subprocedure may be called multiple times. In this example, we called the subprocedure Addie twice, and we could have called it many more times if we wished. Subprocedures communicate through their argument lists. The first time Addie was called, the variables A and B in main were linked to the variables M and N in Addie. The variables M and N in Addie were initialized to the values of A and B in main, which were 1 and 2. When M was assigned a new value inside Addie, it affected the variable A in main after Addie was terminated. Variables in the subprocedure's argument list are declared automatically. We did not have to declare the variables M and N in Addie. However, variables not in the argument list need to be declared if option explicit is used. The variable answer in Addie was declared as a double. The number of arguments in the argument lists must be consistent. There were 2 arguments in both the calling statement argument list and in the subprocedure argument list. And finally, the names of the arguments in the calling statement's argument list can be different from the argument names in the subprocedure argument list. The first time Addie is called, A and B are in the argument list. The second time Addie is called, X and Y are in the argument list. However, the arguments in the subprocedure list are named M and N.